Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you were too hard on her. Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy. Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and, get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zane. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer. But I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island.
Yeah, how about that? It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky. But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers. Come on, mister. I'll take you to Rose's trailer.
It gets better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The scratching hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or anything.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Welcome to... Oh dear, Mr. Wake. I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh, yes. Yes. Please, come in.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry. She doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Hey, Al. Al, what's... Oh.
Barry! What?
It's coming for you, hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
I can't tell reality from dream anymore, but it seems I have an imaginary editor to help me. She's an old woman in a funeral dress. I call her Barbara Jagger. She's very strict. I'm writing faster and faster. My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive, and each day there's less of me and more of her. I hate it, but I know she's right. She promises me I can save Alice this way. She knows more of this than I do. About the complex incantation I'm attempting. About this place. She's worked with another writer under similar circumstances, Thomas Zane. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I'm getting close. I can feel it.
Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me and left its mark. My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
A nice day. Come back
soon. I just stepped outside to catch a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you, the weather's getting heavy. Nights like this make me especially glad I'm here talking to you and not home in bed. Once the weather takes a turn like this, I can't...
You're gonna get it now.
God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI. Get him up, Hemingway. You're under arrest. You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face. Stay right where you are, Spillane.
Right here, you goddamn maniac!
I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
Give it up, Mr. Wake! Come on! Make it easy!
Thank you. suspect in sight!
Okay, men. Keep your eyes peeled. He's gonna try to make it through here.
Oh, damn.
This one's bad out! Bro!
Everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
this is James. Mulligan, Thornton, come in. Over.
Thornton here. James, we got both Wheeler and Rose in custody. They didn't put up a fight or anything. Well, anyway, hey, Mulligan, what are you doing? Come on.
Sit down and give me that.
James.
Mulligan here. Over.
Go ahead, Mulligan. Over.
We got Wheeler and Rose here. Wheeler's drunk or hopped up on something. Speaking of which, that fed had a pretty distinctive whiff of eau de scotch about him, you know what I mean. Over.
I don't have anything on that, Deputy Mulligan. Over.
Well, whatever. Anyway, Rose is just...
I could see the lights of the radio station in the distance.
Take a look, folks. Over.
Gotcha. You better get them here quickly. The Fed's gonna want to interview Wheeler. Over.
Oh, yeah. Looks like they have a lot in common.
I imagine that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine. Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light. Ideal weapon for my situation.
Team one, come in. Over. Team one, this is Sheriff Breaker. Report. Over. Team two, come in. I need a report. Over. Come on, guys. Talk to me. Come in, please. Over.
Just up the road from me, too. What's going on, do you know?
I don't know, but there's a bunch of police cars there, lots of sirens, a helicopter buzzing around, and I think I heard some gunshots.
Gunshots?
Yes, sir, like from a pistol. So can you find out what's going on? Because it's just next door, and they're popping off guns there.
They're still shooting?
No, it was maybe 10, 15 minutes ago. It sounds serious, Pat. I'm telling you, it don't sound like no party.
Well, I'm certainly going to give the station a call, Milt.
Okay.
You'll hear it here as soon as I hear from them.
Okay, thanks.
To get
You're
to the coal
here.
Mine.
Pat, it's Lorna Miles.
Oh, why, hello, Lorna. What do you have for us?
Of course you're going to have trouble in a place like that. I don't want to expect. The sheriff should be helping us normal citizens instead of wasting resources on those people.
Well,
let the trash sort themselves out.
Well, thank you very much for that compassionate viewpoint, Lorna. Oh, here's a little surprise. The famous writer Alan Wake just walked in. Folks, I'm going to see if I can talk him into an interview.
Come on in, Mr. Wake.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Jets, Nightingale. We got him.
Shoot, freeze!
What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
had fallen off so many cliffs it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine. Someone like me to use.
Thank you. most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice? I'm here.
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. Objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
take the facts of our existence for granted, unaware that they are merely a thin veneer of desperate self-delusion covering the vast cosmos of madness and horror. All too often, the stars are right. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Family Occasion. Journalist Alvin Derlis' trip to study the local customs of an insular community in Night Springs has been less than successful. Until tonight.
Well, I'm glad you changed your minds about this. Ancient customs, local mythology. My editor loves this kind of stuff.
Well, Mr. Derlis, we don't want to feel like we're on exhibition. But you have demonstrated the seriousness of your intent.
Oh, I am serious. Really, just do your thing. I'll stay out of your way and observe.
Actually, I thought you could assist us. I'm afraid we are a man short. It would provide you with an intimate perspective.
Could I really?
Of course, Mr. Derlis.
Well, I guess that's the least I... What would I have to do?
Oh, here. Let me show you with a kiss.
I've never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world, taken over by the dark presence, was trying to destroy me. It all felt real. But it matched a textbook case of insanity.
This is Pat Mean, and you're listening to KBF-FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained. You see, I encountered a big-shot G-man with an itchy trigger figure who could use a lesson in manners and a boot in the ass. Not necessarily in that order, either. Now, folks, I know I'm not being very informative here, and I apologize for that. I really should just keep quiet, but I'm just so peeved right now, because some people just shouldn't be carrying badges. I'm just glad that our Sheriff Breaker was there to straighten things out. And if someone I met last night is listening, let me just say, I'm sorry if my mouth got you in trouble. I'm pretty sure you're not the bad guy here. Godspeed, son. I hope you know what you're doing. Now, on a lighter note, I'll be talking to Dr. Nelson all morning. Bye, first. Welcome back to KBF-FM. Hope you enjoyed that tune. Now, Doc, you were talking about life and finding that special someone, that soulmate.
Well, you were talking about that. I was saying I don't...
was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now. I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back. Or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
Wake!
Where the hell are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where you are. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around by you.
You want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello!
I'm gonna kill it!
I had to get to Mirror Peak.
Peace.
find a way to avoid electrocution.
Thank you.
no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Thank you.
had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk. Was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
The graveyard shift may cause cancer.
The place was dead, a ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from a magic lake, using his powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake. Zane believes it's a mirror to the gaping void of darkness above, where some Lovecraftian presence lurks. I crawl back upstairs. I'll borrow these things for my story. They ring true. They fit. Sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up. Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain.
To make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that. could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat. I was close now. I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find.
Wait! Are you? Wait!
Hey, I'm here! I'm coming!
No! Get away! Sorry! Please, it's late! The boss didn't know we was messing with. I didn't know! I swear, I didn't know!
We don't have a wife! We don't know where she is! She's probably drowned! We just said we had her to make a play ball!